They say that spending too much time indoors is bad for you, so we wanted to find out if it's bad for microgreens too. What we did in today's test is we stretched our legs a little bit and we grew some microgreens outside, and we're comparing them to some microgreens grown inside. So stay tuned for the test. Okay guys, we are outdoors for the first time in a long time, and honestly it feels strange. It feels different and it feels dangerous. Usually we're in our little cave where the temperature's set, the lights come on at a certain time, everything's controlled, everything's perfect, and out here it's chaos. But we're out here to compare some microgreen growth. So let's talk about the deets of what happened with this test. All four of these trays have been seeded with 25 grams of daikon radish per tray. They're all being grown on a medium that is coco coir, and they were all top watered. This is the first time we haven't bottom watered in a long time. Simply top watering is just pouring water over the top of this to water the entire tray. The only thing different is what type of light source these had. These two green trays right here were in the direct sun, and these two orange trays were underneath 6 of our 20 watt LEDs. Let's take a look at the par inside real quick. So as you guys can see, these were grown underneath 6 of our 20 watt LEDs from Barina, and the growth on these are really great. The shelf puts out about 240 par to the top of this canopy, so there is a substantial amount of par to these plants, and I am very happy with the growth that came out of these. As for our outdoor light source, we are using the sun. This is completely free energy, and for millions of years, it has done a great job of keeping us alive and providing growth to everything around us, and we've spent forever trying to basically mimic this. Does indoor grow lights do a good job compared to outdoors? Let's quickly talk about the par for the sun. So today is a pretty cloudy day, as you can kind of see, and our par is sitting around, I have to get in the right position here, our par is around 900. I know that the other day we got about 24,000 par on a sunny day. So that is 10 times the amount of par that we got inside, which is just insane. I've never seen par go that high, and I honestly am pretty surprised by it. That is it for our light sources. So let's talk about the actual results. So everything has been growing in their light source for 6 days. These have been in the sun for 6 days, and these have been in the grow lights for 6 days. Let's take a closer look at the growth here and see how everything's looking. So overall, the cotyledon size is really beautiful on all of these trays. I really love the indoor trays. The growth looks solid here. It's nice and uniform. There is nothing here that I am unhappy with. Overall, great growth. On to our sun. These as well are very great. The cotyledons are beautiful. The size is nice. It's very uniform in its growth. Though I would say there is slightly a lacking of color kind of happening in these sun trays. It does appear to be slightly faded compared to our indoor over here. Overall though, I am very happy with these trays, and they feel very firm compared to our indoor, but the indoor are also quite firm as well because they had very substantial lighting. One thing that I loved about the outdoor trays is that the stem color produced this really beautiful purples that I've never seen on daikon radish before. We saw a little bit of this on the indoor ones, but still nothing compared to what we saw on the outdoor. That's all we could see from first glance. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna get all of these harvested. We'll talk about the weights, set some aside from each group, and we'll do a comparison then. I just finished harvesting all four of the trays. Let's talk about the indoor group first. So the indoor groups had 343 grams on one tray and 331 grams on the other. As for our outdoor group, we had 304 grams and 308 grams for the second tray. So there's about a 30 to 40 gram difference between the indoor and the outdoor, indoor being the one with the heavier weight. Now let's talk about the appearance of all of these greens. Groups 1 and 2 are indoor groups, and 3 and 4 are outdoor groups. As for the appearance of 1 and 2, the cotyledon size is beautiful. The stem coloration is really nice. We had a little bit of the faded purples in the stem, which is really pretty and nice to see. Overall though, we got more green than anything, and there was just a hint of purple throughout these trays. As for the groups 3 and 4, which is our outdoor groups, we saw a lot of purple in the stems, and I was very happy to see all that beautiful purple coloration mixed into these groups on the outdoor test. As for the coloration of the cotyledons, again, they were really beautiful, though I did think they were a little bit muted compared to the indoor group. The outdoor group was also slightly shorter than the indoor group, but overall, I think the appearance on all of these is very beautiful, and I really like them all. Now let's do a taste test. So we will start with our indoor groups. I'm gonna take a little pinch of both of these. Whoop, try not to mix them up here. I'm gonna give Mandy 2 and me 2. So this is our indoor group. Right away, it's very juicy, very crunchy. very radishy kick to it. It's very spicy. The radish flavor is flowing all over my tongue. Overall, that's a superb product. I'm very happy with that. On to groups 3 and 4, which is our outdoor. Again, I'm gonna take 2. Here, I'm gonna give Mandy some. Oh, you got so many purples. I'm so jealous. And then I'm gonna take some for myself. Oh, much crunchier. First thing, I mean, like, substantially crunchier. And the flavor,
oh my God,
is really spicy. It's got a ton of flavor. It's definitely a lot spicier than our indoor group. Wow, like, substantially spicier than our indoor group, to the point where it's kind of hard to chew, but overall, I think it's packed with flavor. I think that's amazing. Let me finish chewing that up. Wow, so the flavor overall for the outdoor group was just like packed with spice, flavor, and everything all around. The indoor group did have that, but it wasn't as like kapow in your mouth as the outdoor group was. So overall, winner for taste. Personally, I prefer the less spicy, but if I had to choose one that had more flavor, more spice, I'm gonna have to go with the outdoor group. It was just absolutely packed with flavor. If you're just gonna use one or two of these on top of something as a garnish for restaurants, bam, I would choose the outdoor group all the way, because that flavor was just still on the back of my tongue. It was that strong. As for the indoor group, that's something that I would prefer to have in my salad, something that I can eat a lot more quantity of, and you're not gonna get that super overpowering flavor that we got from the outdoor group. So personally, I'm gonna choose the indoor as the winner, because we like to eat our microgreens in like high quantities. And I think that the more mild flavor would be more accommodating for us. That's it for this test. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna go get some street tacos right now and sprinkle some of these on top, because I think that spice is gonna go perfect with some carnitas or something like that. So I'm really excited for that. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you dislike this video, give us a thumbs down. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the section below, and we'd love to get those answered for you as soon as we possibly can. Let us know what crops you guys would like to see outdoors next. You know, we wanna do this for you guys. We want to experiment some more. So just let us know what you guys would like to see in the comment section below. We have an Instagram and a Facebook that are both at On The Grow Farms. And we have a website where we have lots of great information. That is www.onthegrow.net. Thank you so much, and keep on believing.